Hello everyone, Kili Kadovainen playing Pro Cycling Manager 2017. We are about to go into Tour de France. Let's look at the first episode's stages, three stages per episode. So same stages as it was a few weeks ago in real life. Stage 1, 14 kilometers, a prologue, time trial. It's a bit long for a prologue, not sure where it changes from a prologue to a time trial, but 14 kilometers of time trial anyway. Flat stage and then a hilly stage on stage 3, but not really many big hills, but there seems to be uphill towards the end, so it could be hectic. That will be the first episode. Also, what do we hope to accomplish in Tour de France? In Vuelta last season, we took the mountain jersey. But I feel like we should at least try and get a decent position for the general standings and hopefully take the youth jersey here in Tour de France. Top 5 would be great for the general classification, and then hopefully that will be good enough to compete for the youth jersey as well. And then later on, maybe we need to change our goal. If we do poorly, maybe we need to try and get the mountain jersey instead. But at least from the start, we're gonna go for the general classification. So before the first stage starts, we should look at our race day conditioning. It's predicted to be +2 because it's a favorite race and it is our objective for the season, for the mid-season. We are also waiting for the fitness peak to come in. We are at 64.9 points now. Yeah, that will be. We will probably reach the fitness peak towards the end of the tour. Would have liked it to come in a bit sooner, but yeah, nothing we can do about that. The team we are sending: Bryce Felew, Arnold Jennison, Steven Trone, Brian Cocard, Quintin Pache, Francois Bidard, Mathieu Bourgaudeau, and Geoffrey Conan. So I will have some decent people with me to be able to help me. Jennison is not in good fitness, but Bryce Felew is, and the others are in pretty bad fitness except for Brian Cocard. So my team is hoping that Brian Cocard can get some stage wins here as well, and not too sure about that, but at least he should be able to get some decent finishes. Okay, now on to the first stage. So, first stage is going on. I do not think I will be able to talk anything during my time on the track because it's going to go rather fast. So let's look at a few things now. Riders, the captains of the different teams. We can see Alaphilippe Aru is here for Quickstep. Team Sky got Kwiatkowski, and also names like Vogelsang, but it might be Kwiatkowski they're riding for in the general classification. Quintana is here. Bardet is here for Aguilera Mundial. Esteban Chavez for Orica Scott. Chris Froome is here. I was hoping he would not be here. And also Richie Porte is on Bora. Tony Martin is not someone we fear for the general classification. Not sure about BMC Racing either. Tom Dumoulin, maybe. Maybe. Let's move on. Mollema, maybe he will be a danger as well. I guess those are the main competition, but I'm sure others will show up as we go along with it. Today we are riding in Germany, Düsseldorf, Düsseldorf, 14 kilometers. Now we just need to wait for it's my turn to start. We are starting. Let's go 80 here at the start. Might go a little bit faster later on, depending on how it looks. Alex Dowsett is in the lead with Ion Izagirre in the same on the same time in the goal, but we have a time check before that. Looks like we are actually riding a little bit too fast at the moment. Let's go down to 76 effort. We are getting close to the first time check. Getting close to the first time check, we can see that we are having a +1 on time trial and +4 on prologue today. That's good, that's very, very good. We are closing in on Colbrelli ahead of us. That's where will we be? Will we be in the top 20 here?
That's a good time.
Fourth place, 2 seconds behind. 2 seconds behind, and we can see that Blanco Card, our teammate, is 1 second ahead of us. Could this be a good start for our team? But we are actually riding a little bit too fast. I need to slow down to 74, maybe even 73. So we are bound to lose a bit of time for the next time check, because we have been riding a little bit too fast. Colbrelli, he is running out of steam. He's running out of strength. Will we be able to catch him? That would be a nice thing to do. We're gonna keep it like this to the end. Where will we be? Top 10. Oh, ninth place, 10 seconds behind. A few more people left to finish the race. Stage 1 is over, and we can see not a lot of time differences except for Tom Dumoulin, 10 seconds ahead of Bob Jungels. Bob Jungels, he could actually be a danger here for the general classification. I didn't mention him because I thought he was more of a hill expert with decent mountains, but it looks like his mountain skill is actually very high here. We are 27 seconds behind, 13th place in the end. 30th place in the end, but still a decent start to the Tour de France. We are in a good position, and hopefully we can build on it later on. We are on the second stage of Tour de France. Let's just get into position. We can see that our team is working for us, a little bit, but they are also working for Branko Card, of course. Hopefully Branko Card will be able to win this stage. Let's look at the finish. It's a flat finish. Do not think anything will happen on this stage. We will not be allowed to go into a breakaway, maybe not even during the whole tour. So we just need to sit pretty and wait for the end. Do not think we are going to attack or anything towards the end here. We're just going to let it play out as it plays out. And we go under the 10 kilometer sign. Do I want to get into a good position here? Yeah, I think so. There was a fall not that long ago, so Branko Card ended up way back. He managed to fight his way back into this group now, but not sure if he will be able to compete in the sprint now. We are moving up in front. 6 kilometers left to go, and we are pulling the peloton here. We can see that it's Chérel doing a lot of work here for Aguilera La Mundial. Alaphilippe is also up there. We are not in the best of positions. We are 3.5 kilometers from the goal line. Let's go 95 effort here. See if we can at least get the top 10. Top 10 would be really nice. We are actually moving up a little bit now. 1.5 kilometers left to go. 1 kilometers left to go. Let's do the sprint. Let's see if we can get top 10. We might actually be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8th place, nice! Branko Card is in 5th place, that's also a decent finish for him. Stage 2, Gaviria won the stage. Gaviria have been winning a lot, and I think he's going to aim for the green jersey here in Tour de France. 8th place for us, and I also saw that Michael Matthews came in 10th place, meaning we beat him. We beat Michael Matthews today, but I'm sure he will try and win some stages later on, Michael Matthews, maybe tomorrow, or maybe next stage, maybe stage number 3. We are in 12th place now in the general classification. Let's see if did actually someone withdraw. We see that a lot of people had to withdraw. Alexander Kristoff, Mikael Wahlgren, Arnaud Demare, Regis, Asparigli, Peter Vakos, Bauhaus, Rosen, Ben Fato, Peters, Hivert, Peng Chang. Quite a lot of strong riders had to withdraw already. Is this the start of a Tour de France where not that many will finish? That is a possibility since the game have been changed, so there are much more crashes lately. But we're gonna keep with it. So Gaviria wins stage number 2, and we are gonna go into stage 3. We are on the third stage. We can see that Boaters is leaving into a breakaway. Not sure if anyone else will follow him. Oh, there they go. Cordis, Moses, Dawsett. This stage, a lot of up and down the entire stage. And we can see that there is an uphill finish. Not a very big climb, but could make things interesting. So we need to be prepared for that, and hopefully we will be able to at least... another top 10 finish would be amazing, but top 20, I guess, on a stage like this might be more reasonable, as our acceleration is not top-notch. Maybe you noticed we are in the white jersey. So that's good, a good start. I wanted to see the competition for the white jersey. I think Yu Carfi could be a danger for it. We are much better in time trial, but other than that, he's quite good. Also, Thijs Benoot. He is actually a much bigger threat because he is very good in flats. He's very... He got very strong stats, actually, or about our level. A little bit weaker in the mountains, but if he's in good fitness, good form, then he could be a big danger for us. 21 kilometers left to go, and the pace have just been upped because we entered these final climbs. The final climbs have been started, and you can see the peloton just broke off. It's been doing that on and off all day. Maybe this time it is for real. 24 riders in this main group now. Only 24 riders. Okay, back to 47. Will the others catch up as well? It's a bit hard to tell. Maybe this would be a great time to attack. Then we can see that people are actually attacking as well. Jennison, Pescher is falling, my teammates. That's totally fine. 15.5 kilometers left to go. People are trying to get away, but it doesn't really look possible. Alaphilippe, you will be caught again. But then boulders are going up to pull. This could be actually very intense, this finish. A lot of things are happening here. And the climbs, they're not really hard enough here. Had there been a bit more difficult climbs before that, the downhill, then maybe I would have liked to attack, but now I think it will be too difficult. 53 riders in this group now. Will there actually be a gap to the others? We see that a lot of people seem to be in that group, even a few leaders. So it would be a disaster for them. Okay, let's up the pace here. Let's push forward. We can see that Kokar is also in this group that together with me. That's really, really good. Let's move up in front. 6.2 kilometers left to go. We are in the downhill. That's why I upped the pace, because I knew the red bar would recover in the downhill. I'm gonna take the energy gel. Oh, maybe that was a little bit too late for the energy gel. I'm leading out the peloton. We have 62 people in this group now. I think that will be it. And we are gonna go into that final climb. There we go. We are in the final climb. Alaphilippe, of course, is coming up. I'm expecting Kwiatkowski to come up here as well. Let's go. Sprint. Give it all you got. Alaphilippe is going to win today. He might even get a gap to the others. Where are we placed at the moment? We are in the top 10 at least, but people are trying to pass us. Alaphilippe wins. Who is else? Mollema, Pools, Bardet, they're up there. Who else? Benoit, Sakarin, Roland. Oh, we are gonna get 10th place, maybe. Nope, we are gonna get 11th place. 12th place even. Calmejan beat us as well. Decently good stage, actually. 12th place is okay. But a bit worrisome that Bardet, Mollema, and Pools, they got a gap on us. It's actually... vote Pools going to be a danger for the general classification here in Tour de France. So third stage is over. We started in Belgium and we ended up in France. Alaphilippe the winner, Bardet, Mollema, Pools got the same time, 19 seconds ahead of the rest of us, or at least the main group of riders. Pierre Roland was fastest in the main group. Let's see if there were any changes to the general classification. Alaphilippe is the new leader. He managed to take enough time on Tom Dumoulin. And we are now 29 seconds behind instead of 27 seconds behind. Still in 12th place though. Under 25, we have that one. Caleb Evan is in second place. And Tiesj Benoot is in third place now. That is to be expected. I think it's going to be between me and Benoot. Yep, that is the end of the first episode in Tour de France. More Tour de France coming up in the next one. Until then, I am Killer Cow Divine. Thank you all for watching.